everybody, welcome to my channel. I am Noobsie. If you're new here, welcome, welcome. Normally I am doing Sims 4 content videos for you guys, which would include, let's see, we do some speed builds and we do some mod reviews and let's plays every once in a great while, sometimes casts, but today we're going to do something a little bit different. It's still Sims 4 related though. Today I'm going to be showing you how I make custom loading screens, because I've had a few people asking me about it and over the last few weeks or so, and I was like, you know what, why don't we just go ahead and do a video on it. So I'm going to show you how to do this right now, and this is the picture that we're going to be doing today. And just a little FYI, if you would like to see more of my content, don't forget to, you know, maybe drop a little subscribe. So yeah, anyways, this is actually, it's gonna seem like it's a little bit complicated. I promise that after you do it a few times, it's gonna get easy, I promise. So, because if I can figure it out, I promise you guys can figure it out, okay? So first thing you're gonna need to do is make sure that you have the Sims 4 Studio and get that installed. On top of that, I am also using Photoshop, which you can do the same thing in GIMP too, which is another, which is a free Photoshop type program, which I do use sometimes, but mostly I use Photoshop for things. And then you're also going to need this little thing here. Of course, it opens on my other screen. Here we go. This is the JPEX Free Flash Decompiler. You will need this to be able to extract the files out of the game so that you can switch it to the background that you are wanting to make instead of that, you know, plain, boring blue screen. So I will have links for all of this stuff down below. And also, we have the file number, which I know is probably kind of hard to read, but I will have this file number listed below in the comments so that way you guys can copy and paste it when you try doing this, because this is super important to have. So all right, let's go ahead and get started. So the first thing you need to do is minimize that, not really, but that's what I'm going to do. You're going to get into tools and you are going to go down to the create empty package file here. Wait, hold on, let me make this bigger. Okay. All right, create empty package. So we're going to click that, and then this little thingy is going to pop up here and you can name it whatever you want. And let's see, we are doing tulips, so we will do tulip tutorial, I guess. And then you're going to save it, and then this thing is going to pop up. And what you're gonna do is, we're gonna minimize this. You're gonna click on tools again, and we're going to go to the game file cruiser. Okay, and then this window is gonna come up. I know I keep having things minimized, sorry about that. Okay, I know this looks really scary and like, oh my gosh, there's a lot of things here. Hey, where'd my notebook page go? Hold on. There we go. Okay. So this is where you're going to copy that file number that I was mentioning a few minutes ago. So we're going to copy that. I'm going to minimize that so I have it for later. You're going to put it in this instance box right here. So we're going to paste, and then you're going to click all. And then this little file over here is going to pop up, the scale form GFX. Okay. So what you're going to do is you're going to click that. And then next thing you're going to do is you're going to come down to the bottom here and you are going to click export. Okay. And then right now it's going to be a binary file, which is fine. That's what we want. And then we are going to name this, I guess, tulips. Why not? Or, well, I guess we'll match it. It doesn't really matter. You can name it whatever you want, but all right, tulips tutorial and save. Okay. And then it's going to show you, for me, it goes straight to my desktop. I'm not sure what it's going to do for you guys, because I don't remember if that was something that I had to set up myself or what. But okay, so this window that pops up that shows you where it's at, and go ahead and close it, assuming your file goes to your desktop. If not, I would take the file and I would right click on it and send it. Or actually, no, you can just copy it and then paste it on your desktop. So But we don't need to do that because it's already there. So, all right. So the hard part's done, sort of. And let's see, let's get, oop, no. Okay, maybe mouse cursor bigger for this, and it's kind of throwing me off a little bit. Because I want to make sure you guys could see it. So, okay. So now, super important thing that you need to do next, okay, is you're going to find your file, your binary file, okay? You're going to right-click on it, and then you're going to go down to where it says rename, and you are going to change binary to GFX, and then hit enter, okay? It's going to ask if you change, or it's going to say if you change the file name extension, the file might become unusable, or should you want to change it? Yes, yes, we are. Okay, so now we have changed it to a GFX file. So what we need to do is we're going to open up our JPEG free flash decompiler, which will not be able to open that binary folder. That is why you have to make sure that you change it to the GFX. So then you're going to click open, and then you are going to go to where that GFX file is living currently, and mine is on the desktop. So I'm going to click desktop, and then we're going to find it on here, which, oh, there it is, Tulip Tutorial GFX, click that, and then you're going to click open, and it's going to bring up this warning. It says SWF file uses assets from an imported SWF file, blah, 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 file number, name, whatever. Do you want the assets to be loaded from that URL? You're going to say no to all, okay? Once again, no to all, okay. All right, so now we have this new pop-up that came up, and you're gonna see all these little things here. The only thing you need to worry about right here is this part that says shapes. And then you see all these fun shapes that pop up. What you want is this define shape 6. Okay, it's the big blue square, the only one as far as I know. You're gonna right click on it, and you're gonna click export selection, okay? And then what's gonna happen is a little pop-up's gonna pop up, which came up on my other window, which was not helpful. It's gonna say shapes, zoom should be the same, 416.5%. And both of these boxes checked, and then you're gonna click okay. And then this is gonna pop up, select directory to export. I just make everything go to my desktop. So, cause like I said, that's just easier for me. So tell it where you want it to go. And then after you do that, go ahead and click open. Okay, and then we are going to minimize this for now because we do not need that. And then now you can see we have this folder here on my desktop. I don't know, it's kind of hard to see with my background. Sorry about that. I should have changed that before we started. But anyways, here we have Photoshop that we're going to bring up here. And mine acts kind of weird sometimes, so we're just going to kind of hope for the best. I'm going to click open. And we are going to find that file on the desktop or wherever you put it, double click on it, and then double click the square to open. Okay, so here is our, this is what our current loading screen looks like in game. So what we need to do is make it pretty. So what you're going to do is you're going to go down and you're going to click place linked. And we are not wanting to do the same one. So we're gonna go back to where the picture we want is living, and which we have on, have on desktop, which is right here. We're gonna click on it and click place. Okay, yeah, obviously not gonna fit. So we need to fix that and do that. Okay, and then I'm gonna hold shift and pull down that, and then pull up here. Now, if you think it looks a little too stretched to you and you're worried that it's not going to look right, you can stretch it more on the sides. So it's like that. And then it just won't, this part won't be on your thing. It'll be fine. So, all right. And then just click enter. All right. And then there is our image. So what you're going to do is you're going to go to layers and merge down. So everything's all in one. And then we're going to go to save. Wait for it to save, and it's saved. All right, so now we're going to minimize this, okay? All right, so now that we've done that, we need to pull up our JPEGs again. And once again, we are going to right-click on the Define Shape 6, and we are going to click Replace. Okay. And then make sure it's looking in the spot that you have your file in. And you're going to click on shapes. And then open. And the 6-point PNG, you're going to click on that. And then there's our picture there. And then you're going to click open. And there's a little preview of what it looks like. Okay. And then super important, make sure you click save. Very important step. Okay. And I think Yeah, it's done saving. All right. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to close this because we don't need it anymore. All right. Now I'm going to go ahead and close this window. And what we're going to do is remember that little, that file that we changed to GFX. Now we have to change it back to binary. So it's going to be the tulips tutorial, whatever you named it, blah, blah, dot. Let me fix that. Binary. Then hit enter. And if you change a file name, extension file might become unusable. Or if you want to change it, yes. Okay, so now we're back to our binary. Okay. And what we're going to do is we are going to click import. Oh, oops, I'm sorry, ignore that. We're gonna click add, sorry. All right, and then this little box is gonna pop up that says add resource, okay? So we're gonna do drop down, and what we are looking for is gonna be all the way down here. Where is it? Okay, is the scale form GFX resource, okay? So we're gonna click that. And then in the instant port part, you're going to put in that file name again that we put in earlier that we talked about that was super important, okay? And so we are going to click OK, and there's our file. So we're going to click this, and then we're going to click import. And we got to find our tulips tutorial binary, which is right here. And click that, and then open, okay? And then you don't get a preview of it. So just trust that, you know, it did the thing and it's there. Okay, but then you're going to want to make sure you click save. Very, very important. Click save. Okay. And now it's going to say your package has been saved. Okay. All right. So the hard part is done. Now for the fun part. I'm just going to close this. We don't really need this anymore. Okay. So now we have our original little tulip tutorial package is right here ready for us, and I'm gonna throw these away right now. There we go. So now what we need to do is get into where your document folder is for your mods for the Sims, which mine is Electronic Arts for mods. Okay, and then you're gonna, let's see, I'm gonna minimize this because I can't see what's on my desktop. All right, and then you're just gonna drag and drop just like any other mod. There we go, and there it is, all snuggled in there. And we'll close that. And let's go ahead and check to see if it works. All right, so I'm gonna take a quick little break there because it took my game literally 5 minutes to get to this point. So, all right, here's the moment of truth. We're gonna go ahead and hit play. And look at that. There's our loading screen, and it looks beautiful. I love this. This is great. So that, folks, right there is how to make a loading screen. Now, if you need any pictures or whatever to make loading screens with, I highly recommend Pixabay because it's free and they have tons and tons of great pictures to choose from, which is where I found this particular one. I think I found that one under Vintage Flowers. Maybe, I don't know, I have a lot, so, but I will be putting this up on my Patreon, which is free, by the way, so if you would like to download this particular loading screen, that's where you're gonna find it, but yeah, like I said, that's it, that's how you do this. So I hope that this was helpful for some of you, at least. I know that making loading screens can be a bit tricky at first, but like I said, you know, once you do it a few times, I promise it gets easier. And as I mentioned earlier, I will put the links for all of the things that you'll need down below in the description box. And again, like I said, if you need any custom loading screens that you don't feel like making yourself, Or if you would like some custom cast backgrounds, you know, I have those on there too, which that's another thing. If you guys would like to see a video on how to make custom cast backgrounds, I would be more than happy to show you guys how to do that. Just let me know in the comments down below. And if enough of you would like to see it, you know, then absolutely I can do that. So, or I might just do it anyways. What the heck? Why not? Right? So anyways, I think that pretty much wraps up this episode or this episode. Oh, good Lord. This video. So thank you so much. If you've hung out with me for this long, I greatly appreciate it. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you would like to see more of my content coming soon. Hopefully more regularly. I'm not back to streaming on Twitch just yet with all of the hate raid things going on. But I mean, if you would like to, you know, go follow me over on Twitch, feel free to do so. I hope to get back to it soon, or I might start streaming on YouTube instead. I haven't quite decided yet. So anyways, you guys, that's it for me. I hope you all have an awesome weekend, an awesome day, wherever you're at. And don't forget to be nice to each other, please, because we really need it right now, okay? So be nice to each other, wash your hands, wear your mask, be good. All right, see you guys later. Bye, guys.